Oh, hey guys. Do you know that time when a console launches and everyone starts talking about it, but months later that console is just a rusty can? Yeah, you came to the right video. You read the title and you came to the right video. Congratulations. Well, if that happens and the console isn't selling well, that means it's a failure. Why would you buy an N-Gage when you can buy a GPA? It doesn't make any sense. The newer consoles of this generation don't get that title of failed console. In this generation, we don't get much with consoles. But back in the day, yeah, we had a lot of those. Maybe it's because there's only the big three on the ring, but hey, Google tried. He tried. So, we have to go back like 8 years back in the time and let's talk about the PS Vita. I've waited all my life for this. The PS Vita launched in Japan late 2011 and the rest of the world early 2012. Basically, the PS Vita was a failed successor for the PSP, and that was a downgrade. I personally liked the PS Vita, I don't see anything wrong with it. But many people didn't like that portable console, apparently. You know what? I'm gonna say it. I like the PS Vita. Comparing to the PSP is the same as comparing Mega Man to Mighty No. 9. But I think it's an okay console, it's decent, you can play games on it. Maybe the reason that people say that it's bad and a failed console is because of its games. Uncharted, Golden Abyss, One Nation Racers, Road Trip, Little Deviants, and Escapeland were some of the launch titles. But probably the ones featured are Little Deviants and Uncharted Golden Abyss. I have so many memories of the PS Vita. Little Deviants was one of them, and probably was my favorite. I love that game so much. And I also played a fighting game that I can't find online, I don't remember the name, but also played it as well. This little console has all. If you want to play LEGO Harry Potter, you can. Well, surprisingly, there are still games being made for the PS Vita to this day. Before I was working on this video, I thought that Sony abandoned the console in like 2017, but no, in 2020, lots of new games came for the PS Vita, and it's still supported. Sony actually gave a chance to the Vita in the year where we have the PS5, and that's cool. I've talked about this in my Legend of Zelda CDI games, but I'm going to say it again. After the failed partnership of Nintendo and Sony, the famous PlayStation CD add-on for the SNES, Nintendo was going to do another CD add-on, but instead of Sony, they were gonna make with Philips.
Lots of companies to do an add-on, and you chose Philips?
Curse, don't feel like Nintendo, please.
But instead of the add-on, we got the Philips CDI, and it was a disaster. The CDI used CDs, obviously, and that's it. A console that could have made an impact on the world became a husk console, and is only known by Mordshow and Legend of Zelda, and that's it. Oh, I forgot to mention, Nintendo simply gave to Philips the rights of Mario and Zelda, and Philips, only Philips, made three Zelda games and one Mario game, and they look awful, just awful. Obvious that this had no relationship with Nintendo, they look something you find on a cheap Chinese store for only $1 to $3. To the rest of the world, these four games are the only games for the CDI. But of course, there are more games, but no one talks about them. There's only four CDI games, and they are all bad. The CDI has three models, if I'm right, and they came with their original controls for each model, and they all suck. This one looks like a regular TV remote, this one is just weird, and then we have this one. Okay, this is actually the best one. Overall, the CDI looks like a CD player, doesn't it? Doesn't look like a console. Philips, get out of here! Now we have to talk about this. You ask, what is this? But the answer is, I don't know. It's Mondo. I actually thought the name was this Mondo. Santa console is the worst selling portable console. Only 25,000 copies were sold, and that makes a collector's item. This console is so bad, it was launched in March of 2005 and was discontinued in February of 2006, less than a year. The reason that was discontinued was because of the company Tiger Telematics, a name that you never heard before, went bankrupt and shut down the company and discontinued the Gizmondo. Not many information about this console is available. The only information I got was this, but many games I found were released, including FIFA Football 2005, Sticky Balls, and Gizmondo Motocross 2005. I heard the rumor that the Gizmondo had a cheaply made black rubber, and after some time the rubber would melt on your hands and look like you had a lot of fucking black licorice in your hands. Gross. It's an obscure console. Everything about this console screams obscure, and if you want to pick it up, I found one on eBay for only $150. It's actually easy to find one online, but sometimes it has some absurd prices, so watch out. When we talk about failed consoles, what comes on everyone's mind is the Virtual Boy, and it's normal. Launched in 1995 and created by the genius Gunpei Yokoi, the Virtual Boy had a very good premise, but when you played it, didn't live the expectations. This console didn't have nothing virtual reality, and the only colors were black and red, and also there was a possibility that your head could start to hurt. This console didn't have nothing virtual reality, and the only colors were black and red, and also there was a possibility that your head could start to hurt. And also, why don't this thing have some head strap? That's a grand issue for the console. The only way to play it was like this, and it's not comfortable. The console has some games like Wario Land, 3D Tetris, Mario's Tennis, and Golf. The Virtual Boy is so bad, but it's a neat thing to have. I like the design, it's red on the console, it's so cool. The little Virtual Boy logo on the corner, it's so good. And the controller. One thing that always baffles me is why there's two D-pads. It doesn't need two D-pads. Why two D-pads? Yeah, the controller is imperfect, but if you want to play the Virtual Boy, just don't do it. Just don't play it. It's not good. Just leave it on your shelf, on your room, and don't touch it. Only if you want to play golf. The Ouya is an old console. All started because of a Kickstarter campaign about a micro console that could play App Store games on your TV. Then the Ouya got a lot of support and then BAM! The Ouya released in 2013 and was terrible. For $100 you got something that you could just play on your phone. Why waste $100 on that thing? There's no games I can mention. They were all App Store games. We had, I don't know, Angry Birds, that game you smash mosquitoes and cockroaches, and then Minecraft. The Ouya was bad, but I liked the white edition though. A console that was going to be an innovation that got lots of support to be a micro console that only plays phone games. What disappointing. Now we are moving to Tiger territory. Not the Tiger that we mentioned before. This is Tiger Electronics. Angry Video Game Nerd made a video talking about them, but I only want to mention two of them. The R-Zone and the Gamecom. The Gamecom was a portable console that was a competitor to the Game Boy, and was okay. You could connect to the internet and read some emails on the console. The screen was like the Game Boy, black and white. It was only available in the US and came with a game called Lights Out. And this game isn't fun, like at all. We had other games like Batman and Robin, Duke Nukem 3D, Resident Evil 2, Sonic Jam that had only a part of each Sonic game, Frogger, and Mortal Kombat Trilogy that doesn't have Scorpion and Sub-Zero. But also some games were cancelled, like Castlevania, Symphony of the Night, and Metal Gear Solid. You heard all of this and you thought, whoa, this console can run PlayStation 1 games, what? No, it can't. It's only a capacity that the console can, like 16 bits. Resident Evil 2 doesn't look like a PlayStation game. It isn't worth it to come back to the GameCube. If I recommend a portable console of that era, I recommend the Game Boy Color or the Game Gear. Now we are moving to the worst console I've ever seen, the Arzon. Forget the Gizmondo, the Virtual Boy or the Ouya, because the Arzon is the absolute worst. If I had to choose between a Virtual Boy or the Arzon, I obviously would choose neither of them, but if I had to choose one, I was going to the Virtual Boy. The Arzon was a copy of the Virtual Boy, because it was the same premise, virtual reality in black and red, but this one is worse, because it wasn't 3D bad games, it was all CD games exactly like the old Tiger ones, and the Game & Watch, but on your face! They did one thing right, and that was including a head strap. You had to get that thing close to your face and then use a plastic piece that came with the console to reflect the game. Batman and Robin were still a game in the Arzon, Virtua Fighter 2 and Mortal Kombat 3 once again here, and this console doesn't give you any head issues. It gives you brain damage. After playing that for an hour straight, you're certainly dead. This thing is horrible, and is on the same category as the Gizmondo. It's very absurd, and it's obscure, and it's so infamous that you can't find much about it online, and it's for the good. When a console fails, doesn't mean it's bad, sometimes it's underrated, many people don't know about it, but it has some good innovations and good games come with it. Or you can be like the Virtual Boy that it's straight up bad. But with these examples, you see why they failed. Neither of them included Shaq Fu! Okay, see, if you enjoyed the video, please like, comment and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye!